on to the friction chapter. Everyone knows what is friction. I'm going to ask if this many students have prepared the PPT for yourself. Okay. Okay, Anjali or Biju, what do you mean by friction or frictional force? This is also a part of a contact force, correct? So you should answer. Anjali or Biju, can you hear me? Who is that?
Nama Aditya.
Aditya, what happens? Some noise. Okay, fine. Anjali or Biju, are you there? No answer. Carlin, Matthew, give me answer. What do you mean by friction?
The force that opposes the motion of an object is called frictional force.
Okay. The force which opposes the motion, that is one of the properties. So friction means it is not necessary an object has to be moved. Even that this book is on my table, of course, it is experiencing a friction. So why this book is remaining on the table? Abhinav Bijoy, why a book is lying on a table? Can you just explain on the context of friction?
Can I repeat?
A book is lying on a table. Okay. Can you explain the reason on the context of friction? Neither friction as a reason, you have to explain the cause of why that book is lying on the table.
Because no force is applied on it.
No force applied. Okay, it's a balance force here. But what about frictional force? Is it acting on the book?
No, ma'am.
It's not acting.
Ma'am, yes, it is acting.
It is acting. Otherwise, the book should have been slipped and fallen down. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So, frictional force is the force. The definition of frictional force, not opposing the motion. It is one of the property. You have learned in first chapter, frictional force is the force which is acting between any two surfaces in contact. Whether it is in motion or in position or at rest position. If it is at rest position also, there is a frictional force between the two surfaces. If the object is moving also, there is also is a frictional forces between the two surfaces. But it varies. It depends upon the situations. So that is what we are going to learn detail about. Already you have learned about it. And what is the main interesting fact about the friction means? Friction opposes any type of motion. For example, if I want to pick up this book from my table, there is a frictional force acting against my picking up of the book. Clear? Now I can hold this book with my hand without falling. Is frictional force acting there?
Yes,
it is acting. That's why I am able to hold it. How does what is making this frictional force to act? When I hold it, there is a interlocking between the book and my hand. Interlocking means they both are locked to one another. But if I release my hand like this, naturally the book will flow. If I release my hand, it means I am applying some unbalanced force, no, to release it. Correct. I am applying some external force to release it. Now, it is tight enough in my hand. But when I release it, okay, there is no interlocking between my hand and the book. Similarly, now all of you sitting on a chair or a bench or whatever at your home, but still you are okay. You are not moving. You are not slipping down. You are not falling down. That means your body, which is in contact with the chair, they both are interlocked. So frictional force is acting due to interlocking between two surfaces. Everyone knows what is frictional force. How does it act? Everyone knows. But what is the cause of the frictional force? The cause of the frictional force is the interlocking between the two surfaces in contact. Okay, if I keep my these two fingers tight enough, yes, these two fingers are interlocked now. Okay, now I am wearing a top. Yes, it is still on my body because my body and this a cloth, the material has got interlock. Okay, so frictional force happens due to interlock between two surfaces in contact. And how does it act? It always acts in opposite direction of the, yeah, that is what you have to understand. Okay, so yes, Prachita, what is the cause of frictional force, Prachita?
Ma'am, interlocking of two objects.
Ah, interlocking of the two objects. Interlocking means what does it interlock now? What does it interlock? Is it surface?
Two surfaces. Yes, two surfaces.
Two surfaces.
They interlock each other.
Interlock each other. But is it surface or something else?
Surface.
Ah, okay. Now tell me, with what material the book is made up of?
Paper.
Okay, paper. It is a, otherwise, with what material paper is made up of?
Tree.
Okay. Tree. With what material tree is made up of?
Tree molecules.
Ah, there you come to the answer. Molecules.
So interlocking between two molecules?
Ah, interlocking between the molecules of the book, my hand. That is the one causing the frictional force. When you say interlocking of the surface, how does it happen? The molecules of in your body, because I am a matter, I am a chemical body, correct? That's what, after burying, you are decaying. You are a chemical matter. Book is a chemical matter. Even you burn your body after death, still it is a chemical change. Your body is decaying, is a chemical change. Your body is burning into ashes. It is a chemical change. So my body also has a molecules. So we are talking in terms of chemistry now. Okay. And book also made up of muscle. So actually what is happening? When you say interlocking of surfaces, it is actually the molecules between that particular point. With what point I am holding it? That as well as that book. Did you get that point? So,
yes, ma'am.
So because everything is a matter in this universe. Nothing is extraordinary. You take even the smallest minute particle in the universe, it is also is a matter. You take smallest dust which is lying on the floor, it is a chemical. It's a chemical matter. Okay, children. So I think that's about friction. So we can just run about it. Friction is the that comes into play with it, and it is at opposite direction. And also we can also define, thing all of you have said, also the force of friction opposes the relative motion between the surfaces of two moving objects. So all these are properties of frictional force, correct? But frictional force occurs due to interlocking of two surfaces or molecules of the two surfaces. Now, shall we go to factors affecting friction? See, I am not going to make you to write the notes and all, because already your PowerPoint presentation is there. But some of the things I want you to write is now this, factors affecting friction. That is something you need to know. From this chapter, the questions can come based on factors affecting. See, the pressure, how does I ask you question, the tractor thing and all thing, no? Similarly, in this also, important thing is coming from factors affecting friction. So first factor, you can write now heading factors affecting friction. And if you want, you can write this last sentence, the force of friction opposes the relative motion between the surfaces of two moving objects or objects at rest. You can add that point also, not only moving, objects at rest. If you want, you can write this last point. Other whatever you say, two surfaces in contact, you already learned in the first chapter, okay? It's not a problem. Saman, can you mute it? Bang sound is coming. Okay. Have you completed, children? Yes. So now, factors affecting friction. First factor, the irregularities of the surface. That is the first factor affecting the friction. The irregularities of a surface. And how does irregularities affect? If we move an object which has an irregular or rough surface, irregular or rough surface, just like Kerala roads. Majority Kerala roads are gutters. After this recent flood, you can see some of our, not in our place, but Pathanamthitta and Idukki and all, already all the bridges and you can see, you must have seen the images of in the news channels that a full houses, yeah, houses sliding over and also all that things destroyed. So all these cases, nowadays, if you look at Kerala roads after this heavy rain, you can see it's full of gutter and potholes. So it is a irregular, high irregular surface it is. So you see the people who ride a bike, bus, car on that particular road, you will see how difficult it is. You have to burn lot of fuel also in order to overcome the friction. Yeah, petrol we have to use instead of 1 liter. Nowadays, if you want to travel, you have to use either 2 liters because our road is too much rough and lot of irregularities. So it increases friction. So when the bike is moving ahead, this irregularities on the road will push the, means try to pull that bike in opposite direction. So the bike rider have to use extra energy, extra fuel in order to move this. So if we move an object which has an irregular or rough surface on another surface which is also irregular, the force of friction would be high. Force of friction will be high. Okay, so that is the first factor, how it affect. Second factor, nature of the surface. More or less like irregularities it is, but you can still, you can say that nature of the surface.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, should we write this?
Yeah, if you want, you can just write that point wise, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, I will be giving the notes by this week, but still you can write if you want the factors, okay? Some of your slide, you have written some points, but some points are missing in your slides. So that's why I made you to... Right. So second, nature of the surface. What is the nature? Smoothness or roughness? If it is a wet floor or it is a hard cement floor. You see which is more rougher, more smoother? Wet floor or hard cement floor?
Wet floor.
Wet floor. Wet floor is more smooth. In that what will happen? Friction is less. Correct? There's a chances. If you don't walk properly, it's the chances for you to falling down, correct? Yeah. If it is cement floor, hard cement floor, then your friction is more. So it's rough.
Wet floor, we won't get grip.
We won't get the grip. Grip means the friction is less. That's why you don't get the grip. Okay. If the surfaces of either the objects are smooth, the force of friction would be less and the object would move easily. Otherwise, if it is rough, then friction would be more. If you want to write, you don't have to write full sentence. You can just write. The surface is smooth. Friction is less. If the surface is rough, friction is more. Like that enough. No need of writing entire lecture. Just try to understand that important points. That's what we require for physics. The last one, third factor, applied force. Okay, applied force means if two surfaces are pressed hard, naturally, if I hold a book on the table tight, okay, just like I hold it very tight on the sensor board, very tight, and someone tried to push it or snatch this book out of me, they will really struggle. Why? I applied a more force so that this book and this sensor board interlocked strongly. Okay, so this is what you mean applied force. So how much force you add. If two surfaces are pressed hard, the force of friction increases. Otherwise, it decreases. Okay, that's the third factor. Have you completed? Yes. Yes.
Ma'am, will there be substances with no irregularities at all? All substances will have any type of irregularity.
Any type of irregularities, but sometimes you can reduce that irregularities by polishing. Correct. By marble floor, and if you polish it, you see the newly built constructed house. The marble is very smooth. Correct. You can even see the reflection on the marble floor. Correct. So you can reduce the friction, but you cannot remove the friction completely. Okay, that's true.
Okay,
as long as our world is a practical world, but in an ideal world, the world. What do you mean by ideal world? Ideal world means there is no resistive forces at all. Everything is balanced. Everything is balanced. That is an ideal world. If you moving, you continue moving. You cannot even stop it. So that is known as an ideal world. But we are living in a practical world. So practical world, there is lot of restrictions for our movement, for the objects movement, for objects reaction, behavior, everything. Okay, so we cannot have a world in this situation. We cannot have a world without any friction. You can only reduce the friction. Okay, you can only reduce the friction. Okay, fine. So now we are coming to next. So there are three factors mainly. One is irregularities of the surface. Second one, nature of the surface, that is smoothness or roughness. And third factor is applied force. If you go back to the previous slide. Okay. So you can see the last one, the last picture. I gave the picture of smooth surface. In smooth surface, the person is pushing also very less. The energy which we use there is, it is less. Okay, so naturally it experiences low friction. And in the second picture, you can see that, look at the length of the arrow. So arrows indicate which picture shows the high friction. Okay, in the first picture, surface is smooth. The person is pushing, giving a small push or applying very less force, so naturally it experiences low friction. And the second phase, surface is rough, person is applying more force, so naturally it is a high friction. So that is the how to deal with applied force. Applied force, you have to consider two things: whether the surface is smooth or rough. When you calculate the applied force, in the case of frictional force, you have to see whether the surface is smooth or rough. If it is rough, you have to use extra force or extra energy. If it is smooth, you have to use less force or less energy. So that is small push or big push. Okay, fine. I think that's enough for today. So next class, we will deal to already, you have seen all this friction in your slide. But we will go to a little more detail in the next class. So I am not starting. Yes?
Some objects have under their surface, they would have rubber.
Yes, yes.
Because for grip. Why is it like that? Ma'am,
for grip, rubber means rubber. We can have smooth rubber and all rubber with the spikes. Just like your sports shoes or your shoes. You look at the down part of the shoe, you can see some kind of design over there, correct? Like we call it as a treading. If you look at your shoes, what you wear underneath, there are some kind of designs will be there. Okay. Tanmay, why do we have all that things?
For grip and for not slipping.
Okay. So actually, for grip means what are you increasing over there in order to get grip?
We are increasing friction.
Increasing friction. Okay, but some of the shoes you can see they are very flat enough, so naturally you have to be very careful, correct? When you walk on the very shiny and polished surfaces, there's a chances for you to floor. So that is reduces the friction. Okay, fine. Okay, children. So I am winding up the session. So before